Alright, so what I've got here is the new official Sony PlayStation 3 wireless stereo headset. It actually does 7.1 virtual surround as well. They are very light. The bass on these headphones are actually really good. And the microphone extends out about this far and can also retract in as well. Now, these kind of headphones don't require a kind of like an audio box, like on some of the Turtle Beach headsets that they usually have, where you gotta plug it into your TV and you have to use like, you know, the RCA cables in order to separate the game audio and the voice audio. But for this one here, it's already done on the headset itself using just a USB stick that plugs into the PS3. So you can adjust here both the sound and the voice. On the back of the headset, you have a USB port to charge the headphones. You can also play with them while they're charging, as well as the master volume adjustment here. And let's see here, the power button's on the top here. And then if you want to activate the virtual 7.1 surround, the button's actually right up here on the top. So let's turn on these headsets real quick. The light will turn blue. Now the only thing I found annoying is that this is actually pretty bright at night, so while you're playing you kind of have like this light that's like kind of in your face, but it's the only way to indicate that, or one of the ways to indicate that their battery is almost dead on the headset here. Alright, so now I want to show you what the status indicator looks like. You'll notice that the headset icon doesn't have a ring around it, and that means that it's currently in 2.0 stereo format. And then let's turn it on to 7.1, and then there's the ring. So that in case that's in 7.1 virtual. And I've noticed that in 7.1 virtual, it seems like the treble's been turned all the way up. So you're not getting a lot of bass in 7.1, which is kind of a bummer. So I usually default just by leaving it to the 2.0 stereo. Now the 7.1 doesn't work with movies at all, nor does 5.1, which is kind of a letdown. So you're stuck with basically watching movies at 2.0 audio. So the PlayStation headsets actually work for your PC as well, but they sound absolutely garbage when you first plug them in. So I'll show you my settings, and they actually sound really good after that. We'll go to, you'll see it registers as a Sony wireless device, and then we'll go to properties. Then we'll go to levels. About 50 is how I have it. Enhancements, you want everything off except for the bass boost. So we'll go to settings here. You want to do it at 75 Hertz and 12 dB. Now you can adjust other settings if you don't like it, but I usually like a lot of bass on my headphones. And this actually sounds really good. It's a good even amount of treble and bass. And then we'll just click OK for that. And then for advanced, you want it at DVD quality. I tried CD quality, but I got better sound out of DVD quality settings for some reason. You probably want to uncheck these boxes too. And I'm running Windows 7. For these headsets. As far as, actually let me go back into the settings real quick. Let's go into recording here. There is absolutely no way to adjust, let's see, where's the Sony here? The Sony's on the bottom. There's no way to adjust the microphone settings, these levels here. It won't let me turn up the volume. So unless there's another program to boost the gain on the microphone is total crap. So these headphones are basically good for only listening to stuff. That's it. All right, last thing here, we'll go into the settings for the headset. Go to accessory settings here, audio device settings. And this is what kind of made me a little angry, is that you can't adjust the microphone level. You're stuck with level 3. It would be nice to put it at level 4. I mean, the voice audio is decent, but it would be nice to make it a little bit higher and louder. On the official PS3 Bluetooth headset, you can adjust the volume as much as you want. Hopefully they'll change this in a software update. But as far as right now, you're stuck with a default of 3. And also in the settings, you can change it to where if you want just the output to be chat only, or both game and chat. And also, as well as if you want the audio from, or the game audio to come from your TV, and then just the voice chat to come from your headset only. That's about it as far as settings go for the headset.